welcome you to Dim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through business studies from 3, lesson number 3. The topic it is demand and supply. I'm your tutor, Lucy Mutoni. Let us look at our lesson goals. When we look at our lesson goals today, we are going to look at the movement along a demand curve and the shift of a demand curve. So by the end of the lesson, the learner should be able to explain the movement along a demand curve and also highlight the shift of the demand curve. We start by the movement along a demand curve. In our previous lesson, we talked about the demand curve and demand schedule. We also drew a demand curve from a demand schedule. Movement along a demand refers to the change in quantity demanded of a product due to the change in price. As we drew the demand curve, you saw that the quantity decreases, the demand of the quantity decreases with increase in the price. That is the reason as to why you get that normal demand curve, it will start from the left going towards the right hand side. An increase in quantity demanded of a product is called an extension of the demand, where a decrease in quantity demanded is called a contraction of demand. Then diagram below illustrates movement along a demand curve. Let us have a look at it. As you can be able to see, we have the center. That is the quantity that is supposed to be demanded. But now, from the center, the price of the commodity, from where it is, we move towards the left-hand side to the E1. And then E2. Now, when you look at the prices, they are going to increase while the quantity is going to, we are going to get Q1. And then when it is P1, we get Q1. When it is P0, we get Q0. When it is Q2, you are going to get the P2. And that is the movement. That is the movement from E0 to E1. That is what you want to look at. And the movement from E0 to E2, that is what you are talking, or what you are referring to it, movement along the demand curve. Let us have a look at it. From the above diagram, when the price increases from P0 to P1, the quantity demanded reduces from Q0 to Q1. This is called contraction of demand. So you can be able where the contraction that was from E0 to E1. When the prices reduce from P0 to P2, the quantity demanded increases from Q0 to Q2. That is from E0 to E2. That is what we refer to it as the extension of demand. And that is how the demand, the movement around the demand curve is explained. Let's go to shift in the demand curve. What result to the shift, whatever you have seen that it causes. This refers to the movement of the demand curve to either the left or right side. It is caused by all the other factors of demand apart from changes in the price of commodity. A shift of the demand curve to the left shows a decrease in the demand of the product. So towards the left hand side. But when it shifts towards the right hand side, it indicates there is an increase in the demand of the commodity. Let us get a diagram to illustrate that. As you can be able to see that, we have the D0, demand nodes. We also have the D2. We also have the D1. So when you are seeing, when the demand curve shift from D0 to D1, that is towards the left hand side, that one now its demand has decreased. But when it shifts towards the right hand side, you happen to get that its demand has increased. So that is the shift in a demand curve. From the above diagram, when the demand reduces, the demand curve moves from D0 to D1, D1. Thus, a shift to the left. When the demand increases, the demand curve moves from D0, D0 to D2, D2. Thus, a shift to the right. What causes the shift in the demand curve towards the left-hand side? This is towards the decrease in the demand. One unfavorable test to consumers, when they have the unfavorable test, or the test it is not favorable. Number two, goods being off season. Number three, decrease in price population size. Number four, reduction of consumers' income level. Number five, decrease in price of substitutes. Number six, future expectation of decrease in price. Shift to the right, that is when now the demand will increase. One, we have the favorable consumer tests. That one increases the demand. Increase in population size. There is an increase in consumers' income. There is even a redistribution of consumers' income, goods be in season, and future expectation of price increase. Activity. The diagram below shows a shift in demand curve from D0 to D1, D1. Identify four factors that have made the demand curve to shift from D0 to D1, D1. Reference, get the KRB 2011, Inventor, Secondary Business, Student Book 3, that edition. If at all you want to get us, you can get us through the SMS, USMS to the number. You can also get us from the YouTube. You can also get us from the Facebook. And also, you can Twitter us. Stay tuned to the TV. Thank you.